हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू क्लास 7th, चैप्टर 2nd, क्रिश्चियनिटी इन यूरोप. द पीरियड फ्रॉम 1st century BCE टू द 5th century saw द राइज एंड फॉल ऑफ वन ऑफ द mightiest empires द वर्ल्ड had ever seen, द रोमन empire. रोमन empire covered most of Europe, Western Asia, and Northern Africa. The people of the empire practiced many religions. Some of them worshipped the forces of nature, and others worshipped gods like Jupiter, Mars, Thor, and Frigg. Some, like the Jewish people, believed in the existence of only one God. To ensure that all citizens of the Roman Empire followed the same beliefs, the idea of emperor worship was introduced. However, Roman citizens were not prepared to give up their faith in their chosen gods. It was in such a troubled time that Christianity first made its appearance in the Roman Empire. Who was Jesus? What was the name of the religion that came to be named after him? Jesus was the son of Joseph and Mary, born in the little town called Bethlehem. Christianity was the religion that came to be named after him. What are his teachings? He established code of conduct for men and women based on unconditional love for God, true love for one's neighbor. God is one, and He is the most merciful. He is the creator of entire creation. Everyone should develop brotherhood feeling about others. Loving the people in distress is equal to worshipping God. One should serve others without expecting anything from them. Serving people is equal to worshipping God. If one repents for his mistakes, God will forgive him. Love your enemy, do well to the people who try to harm you. These are the teachings of Jesus. Jesus clashed with the Jewish leaders and the crucifixion. Some Jewish people accused Jesus of blasphemy against their faith. They showed that Jesus had shown disrespect towards existing religious customs and ideas. So they took him to the Roman governor Pontius Pilate on the false charge that he wanted to be the king of the Jewish people. This was seen as an act of betrayal against Roman rule, and Jesus was ordered to be crucified. The crucifixion took place around 33 CE. It is believed that he subsequently rose from the dead and ascended into heaven. After the crucifixion, the disciples of Jesus traveled everywhere spreading his message. Jesus had 12 disciples who were responsible for spreading the teachings of Christ. The spread of Christianity in Palestine was actively done by Peter, the follower of Jesus. Apart from these 12 disciples, Jesus also had other followers like Paul, who took Christianity to Asia Minor and Greece. Role of Constantine in the spread of Christianity. When the Roman emperors failed to impose the idea of emperor worship on the Jews and later the Christians, they took to persecuting them. Many Christians were crucified. Some were thrown in the Colosseum in Rome. However, number of Christians continued to grow. As the first Roman emperor to claim conversion to Christianity, Constantine played an influential role in the proclamation of the Edict of Milan in 313, which decreed tolerance for Christianity in the empire. To pave the way for Christianity, Constantine had to weaken the hold of paganism over the majority of his empire. Initially, he tolerated pagan practices, but gradually Constantine weakened the pagan communities and practices through his proclamations. He started working for the spreading of Christianity. It was under his rule that the persecution of Christians ended. Constantine built churches, made Sunday a public holiday. The Goths were Germans coming from what is now called Sweden and were followed by the Vandals, the Burgundians, the Gepidae. The after effect of their march to the southeast towards the Black Sea was to push the Marcomanni, the Quadi, and the Sarmatians onto the Roman lines in the Marcus Aurelius time. In 476 CE, Emperor Romulus Augustus was the last Roman emperor was deposed by Goths. In the 5th and 6th century CE, the western part of the Roman Empire broke up and number of smaller kingdoms were formed. Byzantium, the birth of a new empire. The Byzantine Empire is the only empire west of China that served from ancient times to the birth of the modern age. It continued on long after true Rome fell. When Constantine, a Roman emperor, declared that Byzantine would be his new Rome in 330 AD, the Byzantine Empire was born. The empire also served as a major transit and trade point between Europe and Asia. What were the Crusades? The Crusades were the series of religious wars between Christians and Muslims, started primarily to secure control of holy sites, considered sacred by both groups. In all, 8 major crusade expeditions occurred between 1096 and 1291. The bloody, violent, and often ruthless conflicts propelled the status of European Christians, making them major players in the fight for the land in Middle East. Monasteries in medieval Europe and its importance. Christian monasticism is the devotional practice of individuals who live ascetic and typically cloistered lives that are dedicated to Christian worship. Monasticism became quite popular in the Middle Ages, with the religion being the most important force in Europe. Some monasteries held a scriptorium where monks would write or copy books. When the monks wrote, they used very neat handwriting and would draw illustrations in the books. As a part of their unique writing style, they decorated the first letter of each paragraph. Monks and nuns were to live isolated from the world to become closer to God. Monks provided service to the church by copying manuscripts, creating art, educating people, and working as missionaries. Convents were especially appealing to women. It was the only place they would receive any sort of education or power. It also let them escape unwanted marriages. Medieval monastic life consisted of prayer, reading, and manual labor. Prayer was a monk's first priority. Apart from prayer, monk performed a variety of tasks such as preparing medicine, lettering, and reading. These monks would also work in the garden and on the land. They might also spend time in the cloister where they would pray and read. In 1095, Alexios sent envoys to Pope Urban II asking for mercenary troops from the west to help confront the Turkish threat. Though relations between Christians in the east and west had long been fractious, Alexios' request came at a time when the situation was improving. In November 1095, at the Council of Clermont in southern France, the Pope called on Western Christians to take up arms to aid Byzantines and recapture the Holy Land from Muslim control. This marked the beginning of the Crusades. Now, let's revise. Roman Empire had people of different faith. They were not prepared to give up their faith in their chosen gods. Jesus was the son of Joseph and Mary, born in the little town called Bethlehem. Christianity was the religion that came to be named after him. He established code of conduct for men and women based on unconditional love for God, true love for one's neighbor.